Greetings. This is Pastor Milford from Word of Faith Ministry International in Miami, Florida. This is praise and worship. Let us bow our head in prayer. Eternal Father God, who art in heaven, we bless your name today. We give you thanks, praise, we give you glory for all that you have done for us in this ministry, Father. We bless your name, we thank you for your blessing, for all that you have been, those that have been blessed through this ministry, Lord. In your name we pray. Father, we thank you for this wonderful, beautiful day that you have made. We are rejoicing. We are glad in it because you are in it, Lord Jesus Christ. And we bless you. We give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory. We welcome you in this place, Holy Spirit. We ask that you take over. Lead us. We will follow you. In Jesus' name we pray. Which scripture says in 2 Chronicles, verse 5. I'm sorry. 2 Chronicles, chapter 5, verse 13 and 14. It says, in unison, when the trumpeters and the singers were to make themselves heard with one voice to praise and to glorify the Lord. And when they lifted up their songs with instruments, a music, symbol of music, when they praised the Lord, saying, he indeed is good, for his loving kindness is everlasting. Then the house of the Lord was filled with a great cloud, so that the priest could not stand to minister by reason of the cloud. For the glory of the Lord filled the house of God. Father, I ask that you fill this house today. In your precious name, we pray. Let us worship the Lord.
Thank you. Thank you. Their chains were loosed and they were free. They sang, I bless your name.
Yet you're here today, ageless one. You are the changeless one, showing love to all generations. Show us your glory. Let your goodness pass before us, right before our eyes. And we will worship, and we will bow down, and we will call you up.
You were come into your holy presence and bow before your throne. Glory to the Lamb of God.
Glory to you.
Good morning. Wow. It wasn't that hard, is it? Oh my God, what a beautiful day this is. It's wonderful outside. That's the kind of weather that I like. I feel good about it. How about you?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. I hope you're all feeling great. The Lord is blessing you. And I hope that you have a testimony this day. Because I, as a child of the Most High God, it is imperative that we have testimonies. Because God is doing new things every day in your life. Everybody's staying quiet. We got to testify. We got to share it with one another. Let's share the blessing. All right. Let me know what the Lord has done for you lately to encourage me, because there are stuff that I need that I'm asking the Lord for and that I haven't got yet. So that will lift me up, keep my faith going strong when you testify. We're going to go in prayer. I want you to make sure that you pray for those that are sick. There are many people that are suffering these days. Many of our friends and families and loved ones are sick. They need a healing. The doctor cannot do it. The hospital cannot do it. Oh boy. I didn't want to go there, but I guess the Lord has prompted me to do so. I went to one of the hospitals in downtown. I think it's called Mercy, is it? By the water. I think it was by the water, because the Uber driver took me around and I see water, obviously, like the river, I mean the sea, by the Bayside. I walked into that, the moment I got off the cab, I mean not the cab, the Uber, I didn't feel right. There's something not right on the outside of the hospital. I didn't know what it was. I thought it was me getting too early in the morning. It was 7 o'clock, because I'm not used to get up at 7 o'clock. So I thought it was me getting off the cab, not feeling well. So I didn't think anything of it, because I'm going to a hospital. I said, well, you know, I'm already there. So if something happened, you know, I'm already in the hospital, whatever. So I walked in. I still didn't feel right. And I knew immediately why I didn't feel right. There was something in the lobby in the hospital. I don't know if you guys ever been to that hospital. There's a big, it looks like a picture of Mary with a kid in front of the registration, by the registration area. And the moment I saw that, and I said, uh-oh. I said, that's the reason why. There was those check in my suite from outside in. So I began to do spiritual warfare. But at that time, for some reason, I didn't feel right even doing spiritual warfare. I didn't feel good about it. So I walked in. That was the worst day of my life. That was the worst day of my life. I was poked 3 times in my arm before they could get something out of me. Okay? And it was hurting. They're moving their needle left to right, something I never experienced before in my life. They did it to my children one time. My wife went crazy. My wife always sued the hospital. So I'm a grown man, I didn't want to scream. And I said, okay, stop. And I said, that's not going to work. I was patient enough for the first time, I didn't feel it. But the second time, I began to feel the pain. So they had to get a technician over to come in and to put, They were trying to put a liquid inside of me to do the test. It's like a CT scan kind of test. But I forgot what you call it. When it's not, they're looking for the vein to put a tube so they can inject something in you to do the test. They couldn't find the
vein.
Yeah, but there's something, when they draw blood on you, it's different than when they put that tube. What do you call it?
Dye? Catheter?
That's the word. Catheter, right?
Yeah. So that's what they were trying to do. So I was, my arm was okay at the time. So I went to the hospital. I was supposed to spend 2 hours in the hospital. I spent 4 hours in the hospital. All right, they didn't do the test right. They didn't do what they're supposed to do. It was a whole disaster. So I left the hospital with one arm like this, okay? So that's when I knew from the beginning, the warning was there. The warning was there. Yes, it was there. So I knew when I walked in, I saw that picture. It's a huge picture of a statue, something you find in the Catholic Church. It was right there in the front. That's not good. I never go there again. Never again. If somebody took me there, I wouldn't say, you know what? It's not happening. All right, so I just wanted to share that with you to see what we're dealing with today, okay? And if it looks like a duck, it must be a duck, okay? If it quacks like a duck, it must be a duck. It is. What you see is what you get. We got to wake up, church. We got to wake up. People of the world have to wake up and see these things from what they are, okay? We pray that God will give them the spiritual eyes, see, to open their ears to hear, okay, what the Holy Spirit is saying to them. But God was speaking to me. I didn't understand. I didn't know what was going on. But now I do. I learned. It's a lesson learned. Well learned. Let's bow our head in prayer. Father, we give you thanks. We give you praise, Lord. We give you glory. And we bless your name, Jesus. We thank you for this day, Lord, that you have made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I love your creation, Lord. I love all that you have done for me and my families and our children. I thank you for our church. Thank you for our congregation overseas. Thank you for our pastors, our members, and all believers, and all that we own, have, and possess. And we bless your holy name, Lord. Father, we thank you for keeping us in good health and good soundness of mind. Father, you have shown us over the years that you've been faithful. You've always been faithful to us, Lord, Father God. When we are faithless, you are faithful. Father, you never leave us. You never forsake us, and you are with us. Even in the time of need, the time of trouble, whatever we need, we come to you. You provide for us, Lord, Father God. You're always providing for us. We bless your name. We give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory, Father. And we bless your holy name. We come before you this day. We confess all of our sins before you. Sins of omission. Sins of commission. Sins remembered. Sins forgotten. Sins of the flesh. Sins of the tongue. Sins of the thought life. What we have done. What we have failed to do. We renounce every sense of the thought life. We take it captive to you, Lord, and cast them down as vain thoughts and imagination, and curse it down at your feet. In the name by the blood of Christ Jesus, we give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory, Lord Jesus. We present our body to you this day, each and every day, as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to you, Lord, as our spiritual worship. We ask, Father, that you will transform us by the renewal of our mind, that by testing that we may discern what the will of God is. What is good, what is acceptable and perfect. We bless your name. We give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory, Father. Father, we ask that you give us a pure heart, Lord, a willing, steadfast, persevering spirit to sustain us. And we bless your name, Father. We give you thanks, praise. We give you glory. And we bless you, Jesus. We lift up our ministry before you, our ministries overseas, our pastors overseas, our members overseas. Bless the members here too, Lord. In your name we pray, we give you thanks. We pray for those ministry, that their calling, Father, their vision for their ministry will be fulfilled for the glory of the Lord. And we bless your holy name, Father. Have your way with us, Lord. Have your way with us today. And we bless your name. We give you thanks, praise, and glory. Father, we take authority now. We bind Satan, every unholy cherubim, throne, dominion, seraphim, principalities, powers, rulers of the darkness, wicked spirits in outer space, in all territorial, in the mental, strong man, spirit, and assignment, and all above, around, and below. We are loose, and you are cast out. We take dominion over you. We take authority over you, according to Luke 10:19. Says, I have given you power and authority to trample upon serpent, scorpion, and all the power of the enemy, and nothing by any means shall harm you. We bless your name, Father. We command every demonic entity to leave this place now and go to the pit and be chained there until the great white throne judgment. Scripture says in Philippians 2, verse 9 to 11, that God has exalted him in the highest place and giving him a name that is above all names, that at the name of Jesus, that every knee should bow on the earth, on the heaven, and under the earth, that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. So therefore, we are seated in heavenly places with Christ because we know who we are in Christ. We are a child of the Most High God. Scripture says in 1 Corinthians 6:17, he who joined with the Lord is one spirit with him. So therefore, I stand before the presence of the Lord, taking authority, Father, releasing, Father God, angel to go forth and ambush, as an ambushment to the enemy, to destroy every works of Satan, every ministry of Satan, every assignment of Satan. May those assignments null and void, never manifested, never come to pass, never actualized, realized, in Jesus' name, curse at the roots and render no effect, judge, spoil, never seated, cast down as vain thought and imagination. Giving you thanks, praise, and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. We cancel every argument in the spiritual realm and every high thing that exalts itself above the knowledge of God. We bind up and off all retaliation, counterattack, reprisal, wrath, revenge of Satan against any one of us that are here today, any of our families, any of our church members, any of our loved ones, our ministries overseas, and all that we own, have, and possess. We decree such forbidden, all immediately, completely, permanently, continually, perpetually, in the name by the blood of Christ Jesus. We cancel every argument in the spiritual realm and every high thing that exalts itself above the knowledge of God. We give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory. In the sense, say in agreement, amen. Our brothers and sisters, it is our time in the service where we receive communion. Scripture says we are not to receive this Holy Communion in an unworthy manner. We are to confess our sins before the Lord. And we are to acknowledge the Lord's works of the cross on our behalf. It should have been me and you hanging on that cross. Jesus Christ and his grace and mercy went for us. We give him thanks, we give him praise, we give him glory. My brothers and sisters, while they are passing out the communion, let's take a moment to confess our sin before the Lord. the Lord Jesus Christ on the night he was betrayed, and he broke bread with the disciple. And he lifted up the bread in heaven, giving thanks to Father God, as we now do the same. Let us lift up the bread before the Lord and the cup before him as well. Father, we lift up this cup, the bread, and we make it holy unto you, Lord. We ask, Father, that you sanctify it. We ask for a special blessing over it. In Jesus' mighty name, Father God, sanctify it in your name. Father, this bread represents your Jesus' body, broken for me and you in Calvary for the forgiveness of sin. That every time we partake in this Holy Communion, we do it in remembrance of you, Lord. And we are also proclaiming your death until you return. Let us eat now in covenant. Let the Lord speak something into your heart today. And this cup represents Jesus' blood shed for me and you in Calvary for the forgiveness of sin. That every time we do this, we do it in remembrance of you. And we are also proclaiming your death until you return. Let us drink now. In covenant, speak something back to Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for blessing this cup, for blessing the bread, for blessing us that are here today. We give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory. Scripture says in Luke 6:38, that give, that it will be given unto you with good measure, and pressed down, shaken together, running over, will fall in your lap. That the measure that you use will be measured back to you. Brings your tithes, offering back tithes, special offering into the house, storehouse of heaven. My brothers and sisters, let us lift up our hands on this offering. Father, we bless your name for this offering. We lift it up to you. We make it holy unto you, Lord Jesus. We ask, Father, for godly wisdom. In this administration, it will be used for your purpose and your glory alone. We ask that you give each one of us here a hundredfold return. We ask, Father, that you bless our ministry and all the ministries overseas that we are supporting, Lord. We pray a special blessing over each one of them. Father, we pray for those hands, Lord, that are not able to give today, that you will bless them. And when they get another chance to give, they will give you more abundantly, Lord. Father, we praise you. We give you thanks, praise, and glory. We rebuke the devourer of us all. In the name of the blood of Christ Jesus, we pray in the saints in agreement. Amen. Please stand by. Our teaching will begin momentarily.